What's good with y'all today, man? It's your boy Top Die, and I'm back with another one of my shows called Real Spill. Alright, today, my Real Spill episode is about why I think us black men constantly keep getting bashed by our fellow sisters and other folks. It's not really explaining. I'm just gonna say, like, most of us black men, we'll let you know that we catch heaters from all type of ways, man. We catch y'all lazy, we catch y'all thugs, we catch y'all this, y'all that, and third from everywhere and everybody. I'll say I'm here to clear the air about some of that BS, because not all black men is this, that, and the third. One, all black men don't freaking cheat, which is something I hear every other day. Now, everybody takes advantage of opportunities, no matter what color you are. I think black men get put out more because of the stigma that's on us. So, of course, everybody gonna think we do everything to the max because we black. But no, everybody cheats. Everybody takes opportunities that they feel that they should take. You know, that's what they do. It's not us, it's not just black men. So when I hear stigmatisms like that and little speeches like that, I just basically shoot that off, because me as a black man know I don't have to cheat on the person that I'm with, because I'm satisfied with the person that I'm with. So if I'm not satisfied with the person I'm with, I'm just gonna break up or not deal with that person and go find somebody that I don't have to cheat on. That's the ultimate goal in life, right? I mean, it should be everybody's ultimate goal if you're trying to get a healthy, good relationship. But if it's your own determination about what your relationship should be. So, one thing, all black men, okay, a lot of black men cheat. A lot of white men cheat. A lot of Asian men cheat. A lot of people cheat, period. So, you take that into account. Two, I don't know why we are expecting. Well, I understand why we are expected, because we are held to a certain standard, but I don't understand why black men have to have superpowers to get out of everyday situations, and everybody else could just get out with a word, you know? It's basically like we have to do much, much, much more just to be considered normal. Just instead of doing something normal, you know what I'm saying, and being considered outstanding, like other folks are. It's cool. It's cool. Because as a black man, I take that as a challenge and I say, man, let's roll with it. Let me see how I can beat up most of these ill-fated standards that's been set on me, and how I can create my own healthy standards and be good in the hood. Just as a black man, I get kind of irritated when you got to defend yourself against everybody, including your own, because first thing they want to say and the first thing they want to do is throw all these false stigmatisms in your face, and you looking at them like, I obey the rules like everybody else. I do what everybody else do. I just happen to be a different color than y'all. You know, it's not, that's why I didn't mention, you know what I'm saying, no other races or nothing like that. This is stigmatism within people themselves or the black community, because it's a lot of my brothers, you know what I mean, that go against the grain and go with these false stigmatism for some strange reason, because it's fed so much that we are this and we are that we just actually condition ourselves to be that way. Me, I'm just so independent at mines that I don't like trends, and I don't like trends that are set by people who don't even acknowledge those same trends. It's people that set trends and be like, I just want to set a trend just to be known or popular. You know, they don't set trends to further anybody but themselves. So I'm not with all of that. You know, the fashion and you gotta listen to this type of music, you gotta be this type of way, and no. You be your own type of way that you feel comfortable. You know what I mean? Stop jumping out your comfort zone and hop into somebody else's comfort zone. That's not what life about. Life about is finding your own lane and driving that lane until there's no more road left. You know what I mean? Hopefully your road is long. And hopefully you can stop a few places learn a few things, see a few things, meet a few people. If you can't do that, hey, I'm sorry about that. I'm gonna be one of the people that does that. So, I'm just basically saying, for all of us black men out there, everybody, we not the worst thing on earth. We're actually kind of cool if you get to know us. Everybody cheats, everybody lies, everybody steals, everybody kills, everybody does all of this, not just black people, you know what I mean? Not just black men, because we're targeted heavily with all of that. But it's on us, such people like myself, it's on us to prove the stigmatism is wrong and everybody else that be talking outside of their neck wrong, because I'm going to keep doing it because I like doing it. So, to everybody that categorized me and my fellow brethren and those little categories, it's not going to work this year, man. 2020, we busting about that box, man. So, I like to thank y'all today for listening to my little real spill rant. Get back with me. I get back with y'all, man. Real spill.